Cross it.
Hey everybody, Dr. O here. So the eye is pretty complex, so we're going to have to break it down into a few different pieces. So in this video, we're just going to cover the accessory structures of the eye, which will be the eyelids, the superficial epithelium covering the eye, and then the lacrimal apparatus, which has to do with tears. So let's go ahead and start with the eyelids. So here you see the eyeball and the eyelids. So eyelids, also known as the palpebrae, are a continuation of your skin, and they keep the eye protected when you close it, and blinking protects the eye, but also helps to lubricate the eye as well. So that's a very big deal. My wife's been having some trouble, and the doctor told her that he's seeing this more and more because we don't blink as much as we used to because we're often staring at screens. So we use screens and technology a lot around here, and I'm asking you to do the same thing when you watch these videos. But if you don't blink enough, then you're not lubricating the eye enough, and actually it can cause these glands to get clogged up and the eyes to get really dry, which is why so many people have to use something to lubricate the eye. So make sure you're blinking even when you're focused on your anatomy videos here. So the two eyelids, upper and lower eyelid or palpebrae, they meet at what's called the medial and lateral canthus there, is where they connect on the two sides of the eye. And then we have our eyelashes. So these are very, very big, robust hairs that are supposed to keep some of the foreign matter out of the eye and reaching the surface there. So that's going to be your eyelids and your eyelashes. Then I would say for me, this is the most important of the accessory structures, the one we talk about the most, and that's going to be the conjunctiva. So the conjunctiva is the epithelium that actually covers the eye. It covers it in two places. We have the palpebral conjunctiva covers the inner surface of the eyelid. So if you flip your eyelid inside out, you could see the palpebral conjunctiva. Then we have the actual ocular conjunctiva, which covers the anterior surface of the eye. So those two layers of epithelium help keep the eye lubricated and hopefully free of foreign matter, etc. So you probably heard of pink eye, right? So conjunctivitis, which we call pink eye, results from any damage to the conjunctival surface. We oftentimes think about bacterial conjunctivitis, but there's viral conjunctivitis and also traumatic conjunctivitis. I actually tore my cornea once, and for several years I would get conjunctivitis that had nothing to do with the pathogen. It was just this traumatic form of conjunctivitis. All right, so those are the accessory structures of the eye. No, I'm very sorry. Still have one more I wanted to cover. And that's going to be, I forgot about the lacrimal apparatus. My bad. You thought you were done. So the lacrimal apparatus has everything to do with producing, distributing, and removing tears. So why are tears important? So tears lubricate the eye. They also contain an antibacterial enzyme called lysozyme. They contain antibodies. So they actually have immune functions, but also lubricating functions. So normally, tears are going to flow from up there at the lacrimal glands, and they're going to go down and across the eye, and they're going to drain in what are called the puncta. So the puncta are going to be there on the inside corner of both your upper and lower eyelid. So tears are going to go from the lacrimal glands, they're going to go down and across the eye, and they're going to be drained at those two lacrimal puncta. Then from there, the tears are going to be drained into the lacrimal ducts, into the lacrimal sac, and then they're going to go down the nasal lacrimal duct, and they're going to leave the eye, and they're going to travel to the nasal cavity, which is why if you're having a good cry, you can taste your tears there in the back of your throat. Sorry, now we're done. Those are the accessory structures of the eye. The eyelids and eyelashes, the conjunctiva, the epithelial covering of the eye, and the lacrimal apparatus, which produces, uses, and then removes tears. Okay, I hope this helps. Have a wonderful day. Be blessed.